constantly breeding people by cutting off their limbs and affixing them to. Oh, that might be a little bit of a spoiler.
No, thank you. I don't want it. It keeps me. Yeah, it happens to me all the time. The story has changed. That was a poem. Got you.
But anyway, I'm really into it. The book, I mean. Not the thing about the limbs.
Yeah. That's kind of dark, isn't it? Yuri made it sound like it was going to be a nice story, so the dark turn came out of nowhere.
Are you not a fan of that sort of thing, Big Papa?
Nah, it's not that. I mean, I could definitely enjoy those kinds of stories, so don't worry. I'd be worried if I would have been told that. I was like, eesh. I'd see that in a movie. I would not want to read it.
I hope so.
Yeah, I totally forgot Yuri's into those things. She's so shy and reclusive on the outside, but her mind seems to be completely different.
It's just this is the kind of story. It's the kind that challenges you to look at life from a strange new perspective. And horrible things happen not just because someone wants to be evil.
What?
But because the world is full of horrible people and we're all worthless anyway. Then suddenly...
Whoa, what the fuck? Anything show up? Nothing showed up.
I'm rambling, aren't I? Not again. I'm sorry.
Hey, don't apologize. I'm seeing creepy stuff underneath, you know, in your text box. I haven't lost interest or anything.
Well, I guess it's alright then. I feel like I should let you know that I have this problem. When I let things like pokes and writing feel my thoughts.
My own body gets
what the fuck?
I kind of forget to pay attention to the other people.
I didn't skip that one, by the way. It did it by itself.
So I'm sorry if I end up saying something strange. And please stop me if I start talking too much.
I'm like scanning the whole background and stuff now. I really don't think you need to worry. That just means you're passionate about reading. The least I can do is listen. It's Literature Club, after all.
Well, that's true.
In fact, I might as well get started reading it, right?
Ah! Don't! Ah! Why?
God, it was like the sound hit my ears before it freaked out on the screen, so I got double scared. Oh, my heart. Oh. Whew. Dude. Oh. Like it went in my ear, so it made me jump, and then she went in the picture, and oh. Woo! I don't like this game. After Image of Crimson Eye. Yeah, that was it. That was a poem. It's the same book. Oh. Interesting.
Yes. I mean, you don't have to, but.
Ha, what are you saying? Let me just get the book. I quickly retrieve the book that I put into my bag. Alright, is it fine if I sit here? I slip into the seat next to Yuri's. Yeah. Also, why did it say backup Monica's file? Should I do that? Oh, you know what? I did have a computer backup yesterday. So all my game files and stuff should be backed up. So that might be a fun test to do. Are you sure? You seem a little apprehensive. Also, this
pillow on my chair that I got, I might have to fluff it because it's already getting flat.
I'm sorry. It's not that I don't want you to. It's just something I'm not very used to. That is, reading in company with someone.
Oops, I forgot to. Alright, nothing's changing. I see. Well, just tell me if I end up distracting you or anything.
Alright.
I open the book and start the prologue. I soon understand what Yuri means about reading in company. It's as if I can feel her presence over my shoulder as I read. It's not a particularly bad thing. Maybe a little distracting, but the feeling is somewhat comforting. Yuri's in the corner of my eye. God, this monitor that I have now, I just realized, it fills up my whole vision. And I'm really close to it now, so actual scary games are gonna be awful. Oh my gosh. Yuri's in the corner of my eye. I realize that she's not actually looking at her own book. I glance over. It looks like she's reading from my book instead.
Sorry.
I was just basing the feeling of
what the fuck? I'm not skipping that. Yuri, you really apologize a lot, don't you?
I do. I don't really mean to. I'm sorry. I mean...
Here, this should work, right? I slide my desk until it's up against Yuri's and hold my book more between the two of them.
I suppose so.
Yuri timidly closes her own copy. Once we each lean in a little bit, our shoulders are almost touching.
Ooh la la. It feels like my left arm is in the way, so I use my right hand to open the book.
I guess it kind of makes it difficult to turn the page.
Here.
Yeah!
Yuri takes her left arm and holds the left side of the book between her thumb and forefinger. I do the same with my right arm on the right side of the book. That way, I turn a page, and Yuri slides it under her thumb after it flips to her side. But in holding it like this, we're huddled even closer together than before. It's actually kind of distracting. It's as if I can feel the warmth of Yuri's face, and she's in the corner of my vision.
Are you ready?
Yeah?
To turn the page?
Ah, sorry. I think I got a bit distracted for a second.
I glance over at Yuri's face again and our eyes meet. I don't know how I'll be able to keep up with her.
That's okay. You're not as used to reading, right? I don't mind being patient if it takes you a bit longer.
Aw, she's smiling.
It's probably the least I can do. Since you've been so patient with me.
Yeah. Thanks.
We continue reading. Yuri no longer asks me if I'm ready to turn the page. Instead, I just assume
she's... Fuck!
Friend.
Hello, friend. Oh, Bert, you scared me. Hello. How are you doing, friendo?
Ooh, get that bug, mama. It's a sky raisin. Get it. Get the sky raisin. Go get it.
She's watching it. That's what she's looking at. Fly.
Instead, I just assume that she finishes the page before me, so I turn it by my own volition. We continue the first chapter in silence. Even so, turning each page almost feels like an intimate exchange. My thumb gently letting go of the page, letting it flutter over to her side as she catches it under her own thumb.
Hey, Yuri. This might be a silly thought, but, the main character kind of reminds me of you a little. What the fuck? That's a wild expression.
Eh? No, I don't relate to this character at all.
Oh god, she mad at me.
Definitely not.
Really? I was just thinking the way she second guesses everything she says and all that. I don't remember her having that expression. That's... Oh, fuck.
Have returned.
Gups!
Let's go, it's been so quick.
Gups! With the 4 months! Holy crap, my dude! Thank you for the 4 month resub!
Oh, that's not the sub biddies. Hold on. Those are the itty bitties.
Get them sub biddies! Oh, look at these big suckers. Oh, say thank you for the 4 months!
Cookie time.
Num.
Oh, goodness, we got something else. And of course, it's a pleasure, the man says. And redeeming the cookie times.
Friend.
Oh my gosh.
We got all the stuff coming in. Say thank you for them treaties. Num.
Bert, you're feeling sick still? You at least taking care of yourself? Hold on, did you? Gups! He's got it! New boss. It's PPYY, right? Yes. Bam! That should be updated. The background music of Doki Doki playing, it's goofy. It has been 4 months, my dude. It's crazy. Like, it feels like just yesterday that we found you. Or you found the channel. I suppose Yuri introduced you to the channel, so thank you, Yuri, as well. All hail the new stream boss. Any chance we can time out Yuri so I don't lose it? Yeah, we got a whole sub gang in here, man. Woo! All right, let's continue here. You just popped in just in time. We're reading books with Yuri again. Yuri in game, not, you know, Yuri in stream. So this is always funny when I say I like flirting with Yuri. Take that as you wish.
Whoa! Gups! Gups, throwing out the 15 bits!
He's making it hail subs and bits and all the good stuff. Say, thank you for the bitties.
Thank you for the bitties. Nom nom nom.
Also, the sound effects are still open. Sub treats bitties. It is a good day. The dogs are sitting here staring at me now. Those sound effects are always available as well. Those will be available. I'll probably keep them available all the time through October, and then I'll have them enabled for like certain streams. Oh! I got him!
Ew, I dropped him.
Here, eat this fly. I caught the fly out of the air.
Yeah, Sky Raisin! Delicious!
They got a free treat. Oh, there's another one.
Damn it!
Did you guys see me catch that Sky Raisin? I didn't get that one. I'm dope.
Sign me up for Sky Raisin catching. Yum, yum.
No! Oh, God, I hate that one. That one's the worst. I feel like I shouldn't be giving treats for that. Oh, I hate that sound effect.
Thank you for the scary sound effect. You want some? Here you go.
Dogs keep switching sides on me. Ugh. That's a horrible one. I kind of wish I didn't add that one. I didn't think it would be so bad, but it seriously, since the surround sound headphones, it comes flying in and slowly goes up my neck into my ears. That's what it sounds like. Ooh. Ah! Fuck! God damn it! Oh, he does it again. Oh, the troll. The troll! Ugh.
Thank you for the troll bits. Here you go.
Ow, jeez, Mama came flying in. She was not expecting that. I think she was watching a fly. And then she saw there was a bit next to her. Ugh. I'm all itchy now. Okay, we're good. Where were we leaving off? Oh, yeah, she's got a creepy expression on her face. I don't like it.
That's what you were talking about. Sorry. I thought you meant something else about her.
Something else?
Never mind.
Dude, why is she going all creepy wide-eyed?
We didn't even get that far yet. I don't know why that came into my head.
What the fuck? I was just gonna say that. Are you feeling alright?
Eh?
Yuri's been a little fidgety ever since we started reading. You can rest if you're feeling sick or something. Your breathing is a little...
God!
Ugh! Dude, I'm so jumpy right now. The heart's... It's skyrocket? That's what the heart rate monitor's for. Oh.
My breathing?
Yuri puts her hands on her chest, as if to feel her heartbeat.
I didn't even notice. Anyway, I'm fine.
Dude, what's with her eyes? She's looking crazy.
I just need some water.
Alright, don't push yourself. Alright, I'm looking at the back signs, and I'm not seeing anything. Nothing got added to my character files. Dude, I get scared really easy now. Stupid trombone. Yuri stands up and practically rushes out of the classroom. What on earth was that about?
Big Papa? Did something happen just now?
Yeah, something's wrong with Yuri. Can you go check on her?
Get the book!
I have no idea. Yuri's acting a little strange, I guess. So you don't know anything? There.
So you don't know anything?
Look, she's got the red dots on the corner of her eyes that were on the corner of Sayori's eyes. Is that significant? Are we gonna lose Monica? Sorry, I can't say I do. Are you worried about her? Or maybe that's just the styling on the eyes, I don't know. But I don't remember her eyes being red there. And I remember thinking to myself that Sayori's eyes suddenly got red in the corners.
Oh, was just making sure that you didn't do anything to her.
Nothing.
Don't worry, I believe you, silly. Yuri just does this sometimes, so it's nothing alarming.
She didn't do it before. Is this a horrible Groundhog Day? Alright, if you say so.
Anyway, why don't we start off with sharing our poems with each other?
Okay. I forgot about that, actually. Eh? Shouldn't we wait for Yuri?
Well, she might be a while, so I just figured we'd get started without her.
Last time that happened, something bad happened. I don't like that.
Is that okay?
Yeah, I was just asking. I stand up. I make a mental note of where I left off in the book, then slip it back into my bag. I should start with Monica, since she just asked.
Fuck you, fly.
I flick it every time and it hurts. Did you choose all the blurb effects yourself? I did. I actually made most of them. The majority of them are the ones I just ported over from the original stream with the commands. I just moved them over to blurb. That way people on mobile and stuff can have an easier time. Doing the sound alerts, and you don't have to go look up a file to figure it out and stuff.
Whew! So, you know, Nelk Boys? What's Nelk Boys? Nelk Boys.
I should start with Monica. Yesterday she seemed eager to read my poem, and I want her to know I'm putting in effort.
I have a sound effect from them?
YouTube channel. I do? Which one?
Hi, Big Papa!
I just said hi to you.
Having a good time so far?
Yeah.
Good! Glad to hear it. By the way, since you're new and everything, if you ever have any suggestions for the club, like new activities or things we can do better, I'm always listening. Don't be afraid to bring things up, okay?
Alright, I'll keep that in mind. Of course I'll be afraid to bring things up. I'm much better off just going with the flow until I'm more settled in.
Anyway, want to share your poem with me?
Uh-huh.
It's kind of embarrassing, but I guess I have
to. Oh, that's me. It's kind of embarrassing, but I guess I have to.
Don't worry, Big Papa. We're all a little embarrassed today, you know? But it's that sort of barrier that we'll all learn to get past soon.
Yeah, that's true. I hand Monica my poem.
Mm-hmm. Great job, Big Papa! I was going ooh in my head while reading it. It's really metaphorical. I'm not sure why, but I didn't expect you to go for something so deep.
That's right.
I guess I underestimated you.
It's easy for me to keep everyone's expectations low. That way it always counts that I put in some effort. That's me to a T.
That's not very fair. Well, I guess it worked anyway. You know, that Yuri likes this kind of writing, right? Writing that's full of energy and symbolism. Sometimes I feel like Yuri's mind is just totally detached from reality. I don't mean like that's a bad thing, though. But sometimes I get the impression that she's just totally given up on people.
I understand that. People suck. You guys are awesome. But in general, people as a whole can suck. There are gems out there, though.
She spends so much time in her own head that it's probably a much more interesting place for her. But that's why she gets so happy when you treat her with a lot of kindness. I don't think she's used to being indulged like that.
Did you catch a bug? Did you guys see that? Mama shaking? Hold on a minute. Or the way they sing thing as the sound. As the sound effect. Oh, Tanply Bud? That's from Letter Kenny. That's not from a YouTube channel. The guys from the YouTube channel probably got it from Letter Kenny. Yeah, I guarantee that's from Letter Kenny. And that's a TV show, which is hilarious. I highly recommend it. Quite funny. It's on Hulu.
She must be really starved for her social interaction, so don't blame her for coming out on a little strongly.
That was a little harsh.
Like earlier.
Game over.
Hope not.
I think if she gets too stimulated, she ends up withdrawing and looking for alone time.
Suddenly, the door opens.
I'm back. Did I miss anything?
Not really. Well, we all started sharing our poems with each other.
Already? I'm sorry for being...